With your parts aligned, next we'll show you how to properly heat for brazing the assembly. Brazing is a two-part process. First, you heat the base metal, and second, you apply a filler metal to the joint. First, you'll need to bring both of the pieces you're brazing up to temperature quickly and evenly. This allows the filler metal to wet equally well on both metal surfaces and completely fill the joint. We're going to use an oxyacetylene torch as the heating source. A torch tip that's appropriate for the part size has been attached. Adjust the torch for a reducing flame, which just means it has more fuel gas than oxygen in it. It should look like this. Make sure the flame is soft enough and large enough to envelop both the tubing and the fitting. Start heating the tube about an inch away from the end of the fitting, then shift the heat to the fitting to conduct heat down into the joint. Sweep the heat steadily back and forth from tube to the fitting, applying most of the heat to the heavier fitting, which of course will take longer to heat. Heat the assembly until both base materials are uniformly above melting temperature of the brazing alloy. Be careful not to let your brazing temperature heat the base metal material's melting point, or you'll damage the parts. If the part has been fluxed with handy flux, the flux will become clear or transparent at this temperature. If you didn't use flux, you can tell you've reached brazing temperature by the dull red color of the metals being used. Now that we're at brazing temperature, pull the flame back a little and apply the filler metal firmly against the tube at the junction of the tube and fitting. If the joint has been properly heated, the filler metal will melt, penetrate, and completely fill the joint. As you can see, this looks like a good joint. Make one final pass of the flame at the base of the joint. Give the joint a little twist if possible to make sure any gas or flux that's been trapped is released. Agitating the joint while the alloy is still molten to reduce flux inclusions. Now that we've brazed the assembly, it's time to clean it. In the last video, we'll show you how to remove residual flux. Be careful not to do this while the alloy is solidifying, or else cracks could develop. If you have any questions or need assistance with your brazing needs, please contact us at lucasmilhaupt.com.